Woo-hoo-hoo! Hell yeah! Don't worry, I didn't wreck, I just wanted to look. This is like freaking 6 minutes from my house. That's fucking badass. I can come here and say, oh, fuck yeah, I'm so glad, happy I found this. Oh, shit. Oh, damn. That's a long fucking way down. Woo! This is a fun road. It's really good. The benefit, there's a lot of traffic on it from what I can tell, but the benefit of that is that it stays pretty clear. As far as, you know, gravel and shit like that is concerned. I'm just chilling. I'm really not pushing it. Normally when I ride a road like this, I push it, but there's other riders in front of behind me, and I don't want to be the one that fucks them over. Dude in front of me is not all that good of a rider. He's kind of all over these twisties and not holding a line very well, but it works out for me because it allows me, it may force me to back off and good. This is the kind of shit you really need to get to know and be friends with before you start pushing it all the way. So that's what I'm doing. It ain't worth going on a road you don't know, giving it 100% and fucking yourself up, and worst of all, fucking your bike up. And if you fucking your bike up here, totaled. It's gonna hit the rock, or it's gonna fly off the edge, or it's gonna hit a fucking car. See, I could catch up to this guy if I wanted. I wanna see a fucking bear. I've never seen one. Starting to think maybe I should fucking turn around. I do not feel like running out of gas out here.
Since I first heard this ignorance, I've been determined to put an end to it. Some people say I should live and live there, but I think it's such a foolish sentiment. Cause I don't wanna be complicit in the spread of an army of nitwits and dim drips on the internet, spreading this nonsense wrapped up in pseudoscientific shit. So it's come to my attention that this whole damn world needs an intervention, cause they're absorbing the lies and it's affecting their lives like a twisted type of addiction. Con men have something in common. They take advantage when your mind's disarmed and gullible, raised up, trained up, brain sucked up in the ideas to really feel comfortable. Somebody's gotta challenge that shit, rise up and go dismantle that quick. But all I really see is cowardice coming from people who gotta know better than this. Being silent is quiet compliance, giving free rein to the stupid alliance. And when you do that, you aren't any better than the rest of them. I'm not impressed with them, so I'm raising up a nation of reapers, killing that dumb shit that comes with deceivers. And we must kick us, rip up, slice through anything they throw at us trying to defeat us. It's death and rigor mortis all day, piling up bodies sitting rot, indicating we stay reaping till the bones just dry to dust and the wind just blows them away. How long do we wait till we rise? A little weight, little statements of lies. Cause every day they be crossing the line and you don't do shit, so they thinking it's fine. But I'm thinking that now is the time. Wait a hood, grab a sight, form a line. Hail horses, the way that we ride, just wait till they see us. Rise of the reapers, how long do we wait till we rise? A little weight, little statements of lies. Cause every day they be crossing the line and you don't do shit, so they thinking it's fine. But I'm thinking that now is the time. Wait a hood, grab a sight, form a line. Hail horses, the way that we ride, just wait till they see us. Rise of the reapers. But what? I'm supposed to be hyped and amused at all the fucking read that I watch on the news, and the stories they will twist so it's slightly confused, and never really know what's the lie we consume. Minds that were fertile get placed in the tombs, murdered by the culprit that's in living rooms. Victims are the ones not critically attuned. They assume that it's true cause it's there on the tube. It's high time somebody go step to that. Expose all of them lies and drown the rats. Beat them over the head with nothing but facts, stacks and tracks. But stats make their brains go splat. I don't really wanna hear your bias. Interview designed to make leaders look pious. Knowing all the while your goal's to deny us knowledge action plan, cause it just ain't liars. Think about it, cause it really makes sense. Easier to rule with a dumb populace. Watch them get pissed till they shout and they scream. It's some nonsense created by the outrage machine. It'd be funny if it weren't so obscene. Get them riled up to the heads full of steam. Following everything with their boasting and memes, so you really can't understand a goddamn thing. Face the truth, cause we're the best you're screwed. Stop watching out your windows and vest the views. While the world gets duped and more confused, that attitude's gonna be the death of you. Choose now and if you're gonna be effective, or let the con man come shape your perspective. Wait on your knees till Messiah's all elected, or be a real force that's feared and respected.
That's one of the unpleasant ways reality can set in on writing. Almost running out of gas. Running out of gas, in other words, is an existential bummer. That's what running out of gas is. Yeah, I'm going all John Paul satire. I don't know how to put John Paul, that one philosopher guy, on ya. Going all John Paul on ya. Oh, see that? My fuel light's fucking blinking. See that? And there it is, a beautiful, beautiful Shell station. Gorgeous. How shitty would it be to run out of gas right here? Before, like, freaking... God dang, 50 feet from the dam. Gas station. That would freaking... That'd be a shitty day.